All right, my most memorable moment with Uncle Kenny. Well, I love to fish, of course. So whenever Uncle Kenny asked me to go to Garnersville, I always hop on it, let's go. And we're gonna ride jet skis first and go tubing a little bit and then go fishing. So we're about halfway through riding the jet skis. So Uncle Kenny's like, hey, I got this GoPro. It's my first one. Bailey, you wanna put it on top of your head and you video you and Wesley riding jet skis? Like, sure, put it on my head. So I put it on top of my head, me and Wesley go out there, we go about a mile out, and all of a sudden, camera just flies off my head. Flies off my head. That was $350 on my head. I just lost it. My heart's gone, I'm like, crap. Not $350. So we go back, I just tell Kenny straight up, I lost it. He was like, gah, it's whatever. So I lose something $350. He's really not even mad at me. My punishment is we go fishing. That was probably the best fishing I've ever had in my life.
My favorite memory of my dad would have to be when my sister Kylie Kirkland ran me over when I was 5. She ran me over by a golf cart. We were actually in Mississippi, and it's supposed to take you 8 hours to get Mississippi, but my dad was a speed demon, and it took him 4 hours to get to Mississippi because he was so worried about his princess, me. So once he got there, he took care of me all the time. I was in the hospital for a couple of days. He didn't get any sleep. I remember he got me a Twinkie. It was my first Twinkie ever and my only Twinkie, but I was hungry, so he got it. Once I was ready to go home, we rented a van and he bought me about 20 pillows or so, and he got me walkie-talkie so I could make sure that I was okay and tell the family if I need to stop for anything. And then once we got home, I had a bell and I kept all the pillows. I still have my cow, Moo Moo, to this day. Also, it's really hard for a 5-year-old to stay still and just like be seated there. So on Easter, my dad decided to put me on the trampoline. He bounced me around with all the grandkids and everything. It was really fun. Basically, my dad the whole time just kept care of, like, took care of me and everything. And like, the best quality of my dad is that he tries to stay strong, which he is very strong, but he's also a very big teddy bear, and that's just why I love my dad. So, love you, Daddy.
Some of my most memorable moments with my Uncle Kenny would have to come during our numerous trips to Maryland. I learned a lot about my uncle, about his passion for his work, but I learned mostly that he has real good taste in food. Without him, I would have never have known that the greatest pizza on the planet would be from Edgewater, Maryland, at some pizzeria right down the road from where he used to live. I've been to Italy, they have great pizza, but it doesn't touch that pizza at all. So thank you, Uncle Kenny, for knowing your food.
Alright, so my favorite memory of my father, Kenny Kirkland, is the time I spent with him in Maryland. It was when I was in 8th grade, and I had the entire house, just me and my dad, in Maryland, and it was that summer that I was going to be in 8th grade. I would sleep in every single day until like 3 p.m., and that's about the time Dad would come home. And I would have had made like breakfast for us, muffins. I love muffins, so I made muffins all the time. But one of our favorite traditions was to go to KFC on Thursdays and get some wings and go to Lido's Pizza on Fridays. We always had pizza. And one of my favorite things to do while I was in Maryland with Dad was he would play guitar and I would sing. And we just would set up this little like mini band, just me and him, and he would find songs that I actually enjoyed and listened to, and we would sing them just to each other, just him and I, just having our own like bonding moments. And one of the songs we learned together was actually the song that we danced to at my wedding. And it just, I don't know, I cherish those moments with Dad because I feel like that's when I became who I am now, because he taught me to be comfortable in my own skin. Just those moments with Dad, just me and him in Maryland, just him and I, it brought about a part of me that I matured just being with him, being around him, taking his knowledge and actually implementing it into my life. And I'm just so thankful for that summer with Dad. I wouldn't be who I am without him. I want to be just like him when I grow up, because I'm not done growing up, we all know that. So yeah, thanks for being you, Dad, and thanks for creating me.